पुरुषोत्तम आई थिंक वी शुड स्टार्ट.
ओके सर, वी शुड स्टार्ट. ओके, आई विल स्टार्ट. So hi, good morning to all once again. This is Purushottam Das Upadhyay, and along with my colleague Mr. Richie More. So in today's presentation, we'll take care. Hello, I'm audible.
Yes, Purushottam, you're audible.
Okay, thank you. So like in every year, SolidWorks 25 years later, even that millions of passionate user, and we are again showcasing another powerful release of SolidWorks version. So 2021, like in the rest of 2020, and this release again, it is very exciting, and we have a very powerful feature and some more exciting tools they have added. So okay. So before to that, I would like to start with corporate profile. Adonix Technologies Private Limited, founded in 1996, and we are authorized reseller of SolidWorks since 1999. And we have headquarters in Goregaon, Mumbai, and branch office Thane, Mumbai. So along with SolidWorks, we have other business alliances like AutoCrypt. It is very exciting things and exciting a solution for industrial vending solution, vending machine solution. We have Simco. It is again very powerful tool or Internet on Things or Industry 4.0 revolution for manufacturing shop floor. It is CNC BMC automation solution. We have Envision Tech. It is metal printer, 3D printer, and we have non-metallic 3D printer, that is MakerBoard. So apart from SolidWorks, we have the these are business alliances things. Who we are and what we do. So as Adonix Technologies Private Limited, we are definitely design and automation solution firm. So we are a value-added reseller of Dassault Systèmes SolidWorks Corporation India. And we handle both commercial and education business in the SolidWorks portfolio. And we have 3D printing solution like MakerBoard and Envision Tech. AutoCrypt, again, it is very powerful solution for industrial vending machine. And Simco, it is a CNC, VMC automation solution for manufacturing shop floor. Again, it is very powerful and most used platform or solution in the manufacturing shop floor. So we have long term relationship, like in the first section or first slide, I've shown that we are authorized reseller for SolidWorks since 1999. So we have completed 21 years of partnership with Dassault Systèmes SolidWorks Corporation. And it is a very long journey, and still we are going strength to strength, and day to day, we are adding more customer, and we are implementing successfully this solution or platform to in each day or a day to day newer logo or newer companies. So a SolidWorks ecosystem, like you can see that millions of SolidWorks users are there. SolidWorks user, you can see that millions of the SolidWorks user. We have number of certified users. We have drop site users or drop site solution. People are using DropSite. It is a dedicated 2D platform or 2D software we have in our portfolio. So you can see that mysolidworks.com member. It is very good credential based that platform where you can create your credential, and you can go over there and you can find out a real time solution, or even you can learn whenever you want or wherever you are. So there is no restriction that you have to sit in one system or where you have a created login. So it is giving you freedom to be wherever you are. You can learn, they have more than 400, 500 tutorial videos over there. So step by step or chapter by chapter, you can go and you can go through whenever you you get time. So that is a very good mysolidworks.com platform. So you can say that number of mysolidworks members are there. We have more than 321,000 companies are there who are using SolidWorks platform for day-to-day designing activities. 3DCC members, you can see that it is very good number. 3DCC is the 3D Content Center. Like it is all the 3D models or standard models are there in the 3D form. So SolidWorks part or assembly. So let's say if you have to use some Siemens motor, so you don't have to design those motor because of those components are ready-made and standard size are available. So you can go and you can download over there in 3D Content Center. And again, it is credential based. So you have to create or you can use that mysolidworks.com credential and you can log in or you can use the same credential for 3D Content Center and you can download. Millions of standard components are there. You can say that more than 33,000 of academic institute where we have implemented or we have provided this educational software and whoever is coming out from the college or institute, so they know SolidWorks because of we have implemented there. And the most useful thing you can get from that user, he's already aware about SolidWorks and he's certified because of we provide certification also for educational institute or students, engineering student. So they are already a CSWA or CSWP certified user in this, terms of SolidWorks. So you can get those kind of advantage, whoever is coming as a fresh. You can see that millions of Facebook fans of we have more than 800 fab labs and software and hardware partners. We have more than 600, 400 incubators and accelerators. So we are adding in each every year that incubators and we try to support them to implement this software initially, so they can create some like exciting or innovative design or product. So this is SolidWorks ecosystem. And like every year, SolidWorks focus on enhancement and innovation, and SolidWorks known for that. So in quality and performance in this year, especially in SolidWorks 2021, they have focused more on quality and performance. So this year, SolidWorks dedicated 58% of its resource focused on member number one thing that you have asked for, because of many times we have been asked that sometime performance or quality or reliability problem is there. So in this year, that SolidWorks dedicated 58% of its R&D resource for this quality and reliability performance enhancement or innovation. So one thing you have asked definitely, so they have taken care and they have implemented a lot of things in terms of performance and quality reliability. So these are areas that SolidWorks always focus on. So, but this year they have there has been an extra effort to achieve some remarkable improvement. You can see that quality and performance that chart. You can see that they have taken care and they have given an extra effort to achieve those performance and quality reliability. So. In next, you can see that in SolidWorks 2020 and the development cycles associated with it have closed more than SPRs than any other release of SolidWorks ever. So you can see that since 2015 and 2021, you can see that chart or graph that earlier it was not that much SPR closure rate it was, but in SolidWorks 2021 they have reached around 25% SPR closure. So you can see that how much they have gone through about this quality and reliability performance issue they have resolved. And you can see that result, it is a 25% increase in verified fixed SPRs since 2015. So earlier it was not that much fixed SPR they were releasing in the earlier version, but in 2021 they have gone to 25% more SPR or verified fixed SPR they have done in 2021. So again, very good number or very good achievement, you can say, in the terms of performance and quality. It was not just about fixing like a small or some like basic features or basic SPRs. It's a software performance report that we report normally when we test a beta version or when they release alpha version or sometime during our any service pack release version. So if we get any problems, we report as a SR, but later on they find out, okay, this is not a service request or that is not possible to fix at that moment or that version. So they convert into SPR, software performance report, and that software performance report, they report to their R&D team and they work on that and they try to find out or they try to fix it, in a later version, all those SPRs. So not only they focus on small or basics of SPRs or service request or SR, so the focus was on area that mattered most to you, that they try to find out which is the SPR or which is the service request it is it is required by the most of the people or they are facing the problem. So they recognize in that way as a SPR and they rate 5 severity label over there. So a severity label like 1 and 2 and 3 and 4. So severity label, it's depend on your the most critical as they have the most significant impact on all users. So that is the criteria to rate any SPR on a severity 1, 2, 3, 4 or 5. So that is the things about a severity. So they have taken in the further step and they try to implement all those level 1 and 2 SPR and they try to reduce all those SPR into severity rate. So these are things like minor within the user interface, and while these are importance and many SPRs fixed this release. So that is predominant focus. This release was to really close on a severity 1 through 4 to solve the most impactful issues to you. So which is impacting the most of the time or the number of users. So they have tried to fix all those SPR in this version. So in this version, their major focus was on performance, quality and reliability, definitely. And it will give you the most impactful result when you're creating an assembly or large assembly or in the drawing, large drawing. Or so those things very easily you can use, and definitely performance it will be improved. So in the performance, in the next, I'm showing over here that quality and reliability. Over the last year, we have seen the significant reduction in open SPRs for severity 1, 2, 4. So in the earlier slide, I have shown that how they have taken care about severity 1 to 4, which is they have rated. So they tried to implement in the in this version. So in this version, their goal over the next release is to get this down to less than 10%. So we may not be there, but there is this is the focus to ensure you have the most robust and reliable design tools. So you can see that over here, they have compared 2019 Service Pack 1 to 2021 SP4. So still it is SP1 or that Service Pack 1, it is going to be released, but they have predicted that until Service Pack 4 of SOLIDWORKS 2021, they are trying to reduce those severity rate or SPR. So that is the major thing they have taken care over here. And it is definitely, it is it will give you the most impactful and powerful solution in day-to-day activities. So now that you are waiting for what's new feature or all those innovative features. So now I'll invite to my colleague, Mr. Richie More, and he will show you SOLIDWORKS 2021 in action. What are the new features they have added? So all those new features are very exciting, and it is very useful and impactful innovation they have done. Okay, so yes. Yes, Mr. Richie.
Yeah, thank you, Purushottam. Can you just give me the control? Yeah, okay. So I think the screen is visible to all of you, and I am audible. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible, and your screen is.
Okay, okay. So thank you, Purushottam, again for the wonderful start of SOLIDWORKS 2021 and how SOLIDWORKS has reduce the SPR ratios dramatically so that there is less impact on the work hampered due to some critical issues in the software tool. And now users can enjoy a freedom of having the best tool in hand to design and then have that tool for manufacturing their product in a much better way. So we are starting with user experience in SOLIDWORKS 2021. And later we will have SOLIDWORKS parts, and we will end this session with e-drawings. Now, just to remind you that this is the first part of SOLIDWORKS 2021 What's New. In future, we will have another webinars where we will focus on specific topics like assemblies, drawings, and visualize in the part two. And in further webinar, we will have simulation, flow simulation, plastics, and so on. So this is like a series of What's New session webinars. So this is the first part. So now let's get started. So in user experience, we have few useful commands which have been added in 2021, which will help you design quickly or probably search the options very faster. So here we have quick access toolbar, collapsible commands, search for commands and customize, improvise to color option, and redo support. So let's see how this works. So in every part, whenever you create some features, it has a subsided sketch. So in the sketch, you might have seen. Okay. So in the sketch, you might see that there is a sketch, but unless and until I click in the feature manager tree, it is not seen. So either I hide it or show it to visualize. But now in the settings, we have the option to change the color for the sketches also. So let's consider that the sketch is inactive and we want to change the color of the sketch. So let's select this gray color and make it green. Click OK. And once done, now you can see that the color is highlighted again. Now also you have the collapsible command. So the command manager can be collapsed, giving you much more room for the viewport. So then you visualize your product in a much better way. So the commands get hidden and you can have a more larger viewport for SOLIDWORKS design creation. Again, we have customization for shortcut keys. So in the shortcut bar, we could do is, we can make the quick access toolbar shown in the menu bar or in the command manager. Also, in the shortcut bar, we can now search the command. So earlier till 2020, it was not possible to search unless you go to the specific toolbar and find the right icon. But now here we have a search box wherein you can search a specific feature, and SOLIDWORKS shows a specific icon for that. And it filters out the rest of which are not the appropriate commands. So in this way, you can search the option. And once searched, you can add that to the shortcut list. So you can just drag and drop to the shortcut bar, and it is useful then. So you can keep on searching the commands whichever is required. So we can add redo and undo commands also in the fly tooltip. Now, once the feature is selected, the sketch is selected, we can add the feature. So we are adding a throughout cut and we will pattern with the shortcut key. So here we are adding pattern. Now, just to note that we already had the undo button, but the redo option was not available in SolidWorks. So now in 2021, we can redo the sketch. Also, we can redo the features. So you can, you know, if sometimes by mistake you have made some changes, you can always redo or undo the features. So this is about user experience, wherein you have the quick access toolbar. You can collapse the command. You have search commands, wherein you can customize your shortcut bar or probably the flyout tooltip. Then you have improvement to color options. So you can have sketches and you can add colors to that. And we have support for redo for part features as well. So let's go ahead with parts. So we have interesting features in the part modeling environment. So here we have a square robot. In the square robot, we are going to look at the features. So we are displaying some display states. And here you can see a sheet metal component. So the sheet metal component is very useful when you create with SolidWorks because you get a flat pattern. But earlier in 2020, it was not possible to have the rounded edge flanges. So let's consider this sheet metal. Here we have the round edge, round corners, and we want to have a protrusion of sheet from these edges. So now with SolidWorks 2021, we have the option of edge flange support for circular edges. Here you can select the tangency and you can see that a propagation of sheet propagates throughout the tangent and has the circular edges also. So it has a similar outputs, like you can select the position of the flange or where is the material. So once you click OK, you can see that you get the edge flange at the circular edges also. Again, when you flatten it, you get a flatten out of this whole component. So in this way, we can create edge flanges for the sheet metal. So again, here we have the same component wherein we have created the same edge flange. Now we can edit the existing edge flange. We can, let's say, reverse this. So let's reverse the flange length. And probably we want to add an angle to this protrusion. So we can add 45 degree angle. And this kind of complicated edge flange can also be created in SolidWorks sheet metal module. Again, the flatten is possible and you can unfold and fold this kind of components. So very easily you can create edge flanges on circular edges, something like this. So earlier till 2020, it was not at all possible. You could only do edge flanges at specific edges and it will not be continuous. So it is a very great enhancement in sheet metal, wherein this difficult task can be handled very easily with a simple click. So here we have an assembly which is in exploded state. So let's try to collapse it. So right click and collapse, and we have the assembly. Now this assembly has textures and appearances. Let's save it as 3MF file. So 3MF file is very useful for 3D printers, and this file is supported by most of the printers. So SolidWorks had the support of saving file, SolidWorks part or assembly file as 3MF, but it was missing some features. So let's see it in action. So in the options, now we have new options of include material and include appearances. So whenever you save a file which has textures, which has appearances, which has text and the material properties, it also gets saved in the file of 3MF. So once you save it, we'll save it to a location. You will see that very easily it is saved. Now again, whenever you try to open the file in any other tool, if for a 3D printer or again with SolidWorks, you could see that the texture and the color both are maintained. Again, the material is maintained. So the file has the meta properties now. inside the file. So whenever you share this for 3D printing, or probably you use it again for 3D printing, you visualize the product in a much better way. Instead of just a random color, standard color, you have all the colors and the textures as well. So better visibility gives a better, you know, results, so that you can print it in a much better way. So that is about 3MF file. Now let's go back to this component. Now most of the power users, what they do is they create sheet metal, and we have some miter arrangement. So here in the weldment, we edit the flange, and whenever we select the miter endpoint, miter trim, corner type, and the profiles are different, you could see that it is not having a proper match. So for example, if we take a side view of this, you could see the profile is larger at the bottom, at the vertical side, and the horizontal is smaller. Now we want to make a quick arrangement so here we have a new option, that is full flush miter. This is very new to SolidWorks 2021. So whenever you click on this feature option in the miter corner type, SolidWorks will try to evaluate the two different profiles, and it will try to merge in a much better way. So once you click, you can see that it manages to flush the miter for both different profiles, and the work is done. So this is how we can use the weldment new miter full flush treatment. Now, most of the power users use appearances to differentiate most of the components in the assembly or multi-body part. So this is a multi-body part, and we want to add appearances so that we can differentiate two zones of this part. So very easily it can be done with going to appearances, edit, and add color. But earlier we could not add a color pick from other applications. So what we can do is we can use a color picker here in SolidWorks. So just minimize the screen. Probably you have a website with appearances and you don't know the RGB of that color. So what we can do is, if you want this blue color, we simply go to SolidWorks, we select the color picker, and we just drag the color picker outside SolidWorks window and just click it and drag it to the website. So here you can see we have picked the color outside the application. Also, let's consider that we want to add that other color to the miters. So we select this miter and the rib, select the orange color or saffron color, and click OK. So here you can see that very easily we have picked the color from this thing. And also we had a mirror, so it automatically adds color to the remaining seeds of this. So very easily we can do this. Now, most of the power users, what they do is they add custom properties to the part so that the properties get propagated to SolidWorks drawings as well. So with easily, you can go to custom specific, configuration specific or custom. And we had a property name, type, and value expression. Now new to SolidWorks 2021 is the equation type. So you can simply add, so let's say we want to calculate the weight or cost. So let's say we want to add cost. We have a new option, that is equations. So equation type is new to SolidWorks 2021, wherein we can add equations and simply select the properties from the part properties. So here we are going to add a part property, that is estimated cost per LB. And into, we can have the mass property from the part itself. So you get directly the cost of the part in pounds. Also, we have cut list. So you can do that for individual properties, custom properties, or you can go to the cut list properties and you can have the equation wherein we can calculate the total length of the material. So here we have the quantity into the length gives the total length. So here also we can do this very easily. Earlier it was possible, but the equation was not there. Now this equation helps you calculate a lot of other things. So in parts, we have sheet metal bent table support. We have edge line support for non-linear edges, that is circular edges. We have color picker for appearances wherein we can pick a color from the website onto the part. You can save material and appearances properties in a 3MF file. You have support for equations in the custom properties, also in the cut list. You can have flush trim for miter joints in the weldments. And you have a graphics manipulator in the structure still. Then we go to e-drawings. So most of the users use e-drawings to view more than 19 file formats. So even if you have a file format, file coming from Autodesk, you have a file coming from Siemens, you can very easily view or measure the file in e-drawings professional. So now new to e-drawings is whenever you open a file, you get all the custom properties visible in the e-drawings. So no need of referring back to SolidWorks file, simply open the file in e-drawings and you have the custom properties as well as configuration specific properties also. So here we have custom properties. So whatever the properties were mentioned in SolidWorks, you get the same look and feel of it in e-drawings. Also we have the configuration specific properties. Then we had a new option, that is we can have measurement. So here in e-drawings, we could measure very easily, but in the measure, we did not have this option earlier till 2020 that you can measure from center to center, minimum distance or maximum distance. Now it is very easily possible in e-drawings professional, wherein you can measure a specific distance for the components. And we also we have the normal distance. Now new to SolidWorks 2021, we have option of measuring WebHTML also. So WebHTML was introduced back in SolidWorks 2020 eDrawings Professional, and we could save the files as an HTML file which can be shared on an email, on a web WhatsApp, or can be shared via pen drive. And it can be accessed via a simple browser on any device. So it could be a Windows operating system, it could be a Linux operating system, it could be your iPhone, iOS, or a Mac device, wherein you simply open the HTML file and you can see the assembly saved from eDrawings Professional. So here we are saving this web HTML. Now in 2021, we have the option that we can enable the measure. So it is up to you if you want to allow, you can allow the measurement. So we can visualize the assembly on a web browser without having any software. Now new to 2021 is you can now measure the same file. So this is a graphics file wherein you can have the measurement of the component. Also, if you want, we can have a pick and place component or option wherein you select the pick and place option and you select the component which you want to move. So even if it is a HTML file, you can see that we can simply click the component, we can pick and we can drag it outside so that we can have a visibility of the component very easily. So this is all happening in a web browser. You have not installed any software on the system for viewing purpose. So very easily we can convert a file and can be viewed in a web browser. So this is about e-drawings wherein we have custom property support. We can measure in web HTML and also we can move the components in web HTML thing. So that is it about SolidWorks, what's new for now. And I'll hand over back to Purushottam for promos.
Thank you, Richie, for showing the great innovation and features in SolidWorks 2021 in user interface of part and e-drawings. So now SolidWorks announced this promo offer in for November 2020 and December 2020. So you can see that avail 3-time benefit to accelerate your innovation. So that buy two get one offer, it is going on for this month and for next month. So you can, if you are anyone, if you are looking to have this SolidWorks more than one or two, then definitely you can choose this offer and you can avail and you can get benefit out of it. So like if you're choosing SolidWorks standard, so you can buy two SolidWorks standard, you can get one standard free in the same cost. And if you are choosing SolidWorks professional, so again, you can get a same version or lower version. So even you can mix match like SolidWorks premium, SolidWorks professional and SolidWorks standard. So this is the lowest cost like SolidWorks standard. So you will be getting SolidWorks standard free in that bundle. So we can do mix and match also, but if you're choosing one same version or same model, like a standard or professional or premium, if you're choosing two premium, then you will get a third premium at no extra cost. So this is very exciting promo offers they have launched in for this month and next month. So definitely you can contact over here in the marketing@adonix.com or even you can contact to us also, or me or Mr. Ritchie. So we can pass this lead to our marketing team or sales team, so they can contact, and later on they will give you the best offer for this. Okay, so please for because of this was our first segment of SolidWorks 2021. So we are continuing in the series of SolidWorks 2021, what's new innovation or what's new webinar. So it will be continued for next webinar also. So in SolidWorks 2021, in the next webinar, we are going to cover SolidWorks 2021 assembly, SolidWorks 2021 drawings, visualize, and probably we'll take SolidWorks CAM in that section also, if time will allow. And the next webinar will be on 25th November on the same time. So stay tuned for the same. And again, it is very exciting. Innovation they have done in SolidWorks assembly drawings, and because of you are using in day-to-day these assembly and drawings, so they have improved a lot of performance over there. So please join on 25th November on the same time. So we will have again the exciting what's new webinar over there. Thank you to you all.
Thanks all. I hope that you have enjoyed the session, and I hope that I see you in the next webinar series that is on 25th November. Thanks all. Thanks for joining.
Yeah, Richie and Purushottam, if any questions are there, we are ready to answer them. In case I don't know whether any questions are.
We could not see any questions, but yes, we are open to questions. We will wait absolutely for a few questions, if any.
Yeah.
If someone wish to ask questions, they can go to the Q&A section in the webinar and they can ask questions. We are still waiting for the questions.
Okay, I don't see any question over here, so I think we should conclude.
Okay, thanks all. Thanks for joining. Have a great day.